Hello and welcome back to yet another video on the University of North Florida. I'm actually repping my UNF sweatshirt for this one, and today we're going to be talking about study abroad, one of my favorite things to get involved with at UNF. By some estimates, you could say that I am currently on my 8th study abroad program slash semester, so I'm a big fan and I think you should be too. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about what kind of study abroad programs are offered at UNF, how you can finance those experiences, what my personal experiences with study abroad have been. All right, so first things first, there are three main types of study abroad at UNF. The first is going to be faculty-led programs. What this means is, like, for 10 days during winter, spring, or May break, you will go with a faculty member to a foreign destination. It'll normally be tied to a class you're in, or you'll have a lot of prep beforehand, and the faculty member will show you around and you'll have more of a set itinerary. So it's just like a very fun trip. So the second type is summer programs or summer semesters, and this is normally going to be around 6 weeks and up to 6 credits at a partner university. And the third type is going to be just exchange semesters, so where you're going to a partner university for the full semester, taking like a full set of classes, and those credits will apply back to UNF. All right, so part two of this video is going to be about financing. You might be thinking, yeah, I'd love to do a study abroad. It sounds like such a great experience. I just don't think I'll be able to afford it. Stop that thinking right there, because at UNF, you absolutely might be able to. The reason being is that, first and foremost, at any partner university, all you're going to be doing is paying the same tuition that you'd pay at UNF, plus all of your same scholarships will apply. Like, if you have like academic scholarships or your Florida Bright Futures or Florida Prepaid, to the most of my knowledge, all of that will work abroad. So it's essentially like you're going to UNF just somewhere else. Now, on top of that, you got tons of options to find funding or scholarships. The first one is going to be a TLO, or a transformational learning opportunity, which is a little extra cash that UNF puts aside to give to students who are doing like research or maybe an internship. It also applies to several study abroad programs. So keep your eye out for TLOs, because that's gonna be just extra money you can apply for. All right, so next up is the Student Affairs International Learning Scholarship, also known as SAILS. Now, this one's pretty great because this one isn't merit-based. All you have to do is write 3 pretty killer essays and get a letter of recommendation, and you can get up to $1,500 for short-term programs and $2,500 for semester exchanges. And what's pretty great about this one as well is that if you want to do multiple study abroad programs, you can actually apply for this one multiple times. However, you are docked points on your essays for every time you apply. For example, even if I wrote the most perfect essays right now and got just the most amazing letter of recommendation, I've applied for that scholarship too many times. I simply can't get it anymore, but it's a great opportunity if you're just trying to get some extra money for your program. All right, so next up is college-specific scholarships. So if you are in the Coggin College of Business, they will have their own inventory of scholarships just for Coggin study abroad programs. This is true for other colleges as well. However, in my experience, Coggin has like the deepest pockets. But say, for example, you're in the College of Arts and Sciences and you want to do a language study abroad program, there will be extra scholarships specifically for either your program or your college. There's also Hicks Honors College study abroad scholarships, and these are phenomenal. So if you are even thinking about doing Hicks Honors and you want to do study abroad, you absolutely have to, because these scholarships can make study abroad just so accessible. Plus, Honors has its own specific study abroad program, so there's just more opportunities and more funding if you are in Honors. As I mentioned earlier, I've been on a lot of study abroad programs, and the only thing that's made all of these opportunities possible for me has been applying for just as many scholarships and for as much funding as I could possibly get my hands on. So on average, I probably write 5 to 10 scholarship essays a year, and for me, it has been the highest paying job per hour that I've ever had. Like, at this point right now, I get paid to be on study abroad, and if you play your cards right, that could be you too. I'm not special, I've just applied for everything under the sun when it comes to study abroad, because it's something that I really, really like, and it's something I wanted to make possible for myself. So, before I talk about how great my experiences were, just know that that could be you too if you put in the work. You can do it, I promise. So if you're weighing the pros and cons of UNF, know that study abroad, in my opinion, is a big pro, and you should definitely weigh that in your decision. But ultimately, there's plenty of other content on my channel about if you should go to UNF or not, so go check that out. But wherever you go, do study abroad. Don't go through college and not study abroad. Like, that would be silly. I'm telling you, it'd be silly for you to do that. So apply for scholarships, get the money you need to go, and go. We'll see you next time.